As 1.3 billion people are in lockdown, perhaps something that we do not think of is what's going through our state of mind, our mental health. You may think this is trivial, but actually it's not. Do you find that you're behaving different from your usual personality? That could be a clue that you need to stop and think about yourself. Also, remember that India is among the most depressed countries in the world. And the suicide rate among women, according to the World Health Organization, is the third highest in the world. Somebody has decided to put their energies on mental health at this difficult and challenging time for the country. It's my pleasure to welcome on the program Neerja Birla. Neerja is the founder and chairperson of Mpower. Mpower Foundation has joined hands with the Maharashtra government and the local civic authorities there to start a helpline devoted to mental health. Neerja, thank you so much for raising this very, very critically important conversation and something that is often overlooked. What made you decide to start this helpline, and what will this helpline actually be doing?
Hi, Varkha. Thanks for having me on this show. I think the objective of the helpline is basically to reach out to people who don't have access to mental health services otherwise. It also helps people who are going through a crisis, who just want that reassurance, who just want to hear a voice at the other end, to kind of tide through and tide over just that moment when you're feeling really low. The best way to reach out to people is through a helpline, because, you know, everybody, especially at this point in time when we're all going through social distancing and a lot of us are living alone, you just want to talk to somebody. Yeah. Helpline, we're hoping that a helpline will help reach out to people who can then talk to our therapists at the other end. We have a good team of therapists who are attending to these calls. And I'm really hoping that we're able to make that slight difference at such a disruptive and at a time of crisis.
And I just want to confirm that the people who will be picking up the phone if we dial this helpline are all trained professionals at different levels. You mentioned therapists, but these are people who will know how to counsel somebody through the conversation.
Oh, absolutely. All of them are trained clinicians. They're all counselors, psychologists and psychiatrists, and all of them are trained. The advice that they will be offering is very much on point. Pretty much like what you would go to a counseling center. Yes, they all are very absolutely trained professionals. I'm really happy with the quality of therapists that we have. We have a really good team and they're doing a great job.
Now, Neerja, one of the fallacies and one of the mistakes that everybody tends to make when it comes to mental health is to treat it as some sort of luxury or self-indulgence. It's the last thing we think about. Now, I think it's really important to explain to people that just like you may have a physical ailment, you can have a mental ailment. And this is not a luxury. This is not some rich person's entitlement. And I really want you, I know we've spoken about this before, to explain to our viewers that right now they could be going through any range of emotions and that is okay. It's not some reaction of the elite and the privileged.
You're absolutely right, Barkha, and that is something that we've been grappling with and trying to change mindsets about. The general feeling is that mental health issues, cannot happen to you. And people always put it on the back burner. People always think that, this is something that one is just going to tide over. And I think because it is an unknown quantity, it is something that you don't see like a physical illness. One very often just overlooks this aspect of your health. Having said that, I think mental health and mental wellness are of prime importance. And I think during this lockdown period, I think all of us are really coming to terms and coming face to face with a lot of issues, which probably tend to just get hidden in the normal course of life. So, I mean, typically now, under this situation, one would get exposed and one would have a lot of feelings of paranoia, anxiety. One could be feeling low. One could be feeling depressed. And this is all very normal at this point in time. It's fine. You are bound to feel these symptoms. But what you need to understand that it's okay to not be okay, but it's not okay not to seek help. You have to seek help. You must seek help. And you must also be, good with yourself and easy on yourself that if you are feeling any, if you are feeling any of these symptoms, it's really okay because these are very trying times. All of us are going through a whole gamut of, you know, situations and emotions that we may not have felt otherwise. So if you are feeling anxious, then you must reach out. I don't think there's anything wrong. And I think the faster people realize that, I think the better it will be for all of us as a society. In fact, just to give you some numbers, we started the helpline yesterday at 9 in the morning, and it's a 24/7 line. This morning we'd already clocked about 1100 calls. So that's the kind of, need there is for a helpline like that.
I'm so glad you're doing this, but I do have to ask you, in my team, I've been spending a lot of time with the poorest of our poor, migrant workers who've either been displaced or who literally are now struggling and battling for food. And while the government gets its logistics together to get them food, how are you going to ensure that this helpline is able to go beyond the middle class, the upper middle class, even lower income groups, to the poorest of poor who are so busy battling for survival that they're not even noticing what's happening to their mental health in the process?
Yeah. You're absolutely right, Barkha. I mean, especially for the economically challenged, mental health for them is just, I mean, they don't even have the wherewithal or the time or the mental space to even think about that. So what we're trying to do is really reach out to the interiors of Maharashtra. And we're going to use the radio as a platform. I am reaching out to all the radio channels, actually, to broadcast this news, because I do believe that radio reach is just fantastic. So, and it's a toll-free line. It's free of cost. We have therapists who are exclusively for Marathi, keeping in mind and hoping that people from the interior rural areas would also reach out. So with the help of radio, I'm really hoping that we reach out to the interiors and make it available for them as well.
Neerja, one more question, and I just want to tell all our viewers, the number of this helpline is on our screen as we speak. Please pay attention. मैं हिंदी में भी बोलूंगी, अगर आप में से कोई मदद चाहता है और आप समझ नहीं पाते कि वो मदद हो सकता है आपके माइंड में, आपके दिल में कुछ पैनिक हो, कुछ टेंशन हो, तो प्लीज आप इस नंबर पर डायल कर सकते हैं. ये हेल्पलाइन है अगर आप महाराष्ट्र में रहते हो. द नंबर्स आर ऑन योर स्क्रीन. नीरजा, आई वांट टू आस्क यू, कैन यू टेक दिस आउटसाइड ऑफ महाराष्ट्र? हैव यू बीन इन टच विद अदर गवर्नमेंट्स? डू यू नॉट राइट नाउ हैव द बैंडविड्थ और द लॉजिस्टिक्स टू बी एबल टू डू दैट?
So we've not officially taken it to any other state, but yesterday we did get calls which were out of the state of Maharashtra, which we were answering. So here, at the behest of Aditya Thackeray and with the support of Mr. Parveen Pardesi, we were able to get the support of the state as well as the BMC to have the services available for the people. People from outside of Maharashtra can also make calls. We did get calls yesterday and our therapists did attend to them. So in a sense, it is already available in the nation, but yes, I haven't yet made it official with any of the other state governments. I'm hoping to do that. And of course, we will ramp up. We have the bandwidth and I'd be very happy to do that.
Very glad to hear that. One last question. Women and mental health becomes sometimes an invisible subject because women tend to multitask, take on more burden than men. And this is a moment when women are probably carrying double the load. You have children at home, children not going to school. You have partners at home. You have women who are either juggling careers while working from home, or very poor women who are still worried about livelihood, who still have to worry about putting food on the table. Your study, your research must have shown that mental health has a disproportionate impact on women in India. And what would you like to say in the end about that?
So what you're saying is right, Barkha, that women are more susceptible to mental health concerns because of their physiological makeup, as well as for all the circumstantial situations that they are faced with, whether it is work, home, the pressures that are on them. So everything put together, women are definitely far more susceptible. And I think we need to take care of ourselves much more than we do. We have to take time aside and indulge in some amount of self-care. Having said that, I think men also are susceptible because they have their own pressures to deal with. And in fact, very often, men are the ones who find it very difficult to come to terms with it. So I think more and more, as we're seeing, I think women are being able to talk about it, are able to come out with it. I think women are able to talk about it. Men are finding it difficult. And I think it's the whole gender stereotype that comes in where, you know, the whole observation, the perception is that men are not allowed to cry, or men can't be, can't express themselves, or men are not supposed to be weak. Yeah. And that is proving to be a huge stigma, which actually prevents men from acknowledging their feelings and their mental health concerns. So yes, women are definitely far more susceptible, but men too have their own shares of issues and problems. And I think it's only fair that I think everybody, you know, one needs to really be non-judgmental and understand that both genders have their own issues, and need to realize that we all should take some time and indulge in self-care, look after ourselves, and really approach professional help and seek the help if we don't feel well. It could be even just a simple, I mean, even if you're feeling a little anxious, I think you should reach out and you know, call the helpline. It could just be a minute, or it could be just 2 minutes, but you'll just feel a lot more calmer and continue with the rest of your day.
Well, I have to thank you for what you're doing, because I know each one of us is going through a roller coaster of emotions for different reasons, and especially essential services who are still out there, doctors, nurses, healthcare professionals, you know, shopkeepers, the safai karamcharis, and journalists as well, people out there still in this difficult time, as well as people cooped up inside. Neerja, I think what you're doing is a perfect example of how private-public partnerships can develop. So congratulations and thank you for doing this. And we'll be sure to disseminate and amplify the message of your helpline as much as possible. Remember, viewers, that number is on your screen. If you feel the need, pick up the phone and dial. You have trained practitioners at the other end there ready to help you. Neerja Birla, pleasure having you on the program.